This is a demonstration of how to create a transfer database for the PortaCount. A transfer database is stored on a thumb drive and allows you to run the PortaCount without the need for a dedicated computer. The first step is to insert a formatted thumb drive into a USB port on your computer. Second step is to open up FitPro software. What we're trying to do is select the source database, the main database that's going to be located on your PC where all information regarding your fit testing can be housed. Once we've got that selected database, in this circumstance called RAECO Data, we then open up under the database heading the flash drive database exchange. From there, we've identified our source database, and now we're going to create a name for our transfer database. You'll notice that the source database is an MDF file, our transfer database is an XML type file. In this case, we look and search for our removable disk, the thumb drive we inserted. Once we've selected the thumb drive, we create the file name that we're going to use as our transfer database name. In this case, we'll call it Web Demo. Clicking Save forces that file to be saved to the thumb drive in the slot that we've located. Once complete, we get a confirmation that the file name has been transferred, the database has been created. From here, we can exit out of the software program and now take our thumb drive and insert it into our PortaCount instrument. Just to confirm, we've opened up My Computer, we're opening our removable disk, and we're confirming that the Web Demo XML file is in fact on our thumb drive. Now that we've created the XML transfer database on the thumb drive, we move the thumb drive and place into the PortaCount either one of the USB slots on the back. Next, go to the Database tab, select Database, and from the drop-down list, select the database that we want to use. In this case, we'd label this Web Demo. When you have the selected database that you want to use as your transfer drive, simply load it into the system. Once loaded, we can move to actually conducting fit tests. Now that we've confirmed that our file, Web Demo, is the selected database, we can enter the fit test options. In this case, we're going to skip through the daily check, but this is an activity that you'd want to perform each day that you're using the instrument. For the purpose of this demo, we're going to skip the process. Now we've got our Web Demo selected. If we had information in that Web Demo file that we had transferred over from the computer, that would be populated here. In this case, since we didn't populate it with anything other than a transfer XML database, we'll begin our testing by entering information. In this case, if we wanted to put in a new individual, we'd simply load in their details. In this case, we're going to generate a fit test person called Test. We'll make up a number and can add whatever information that we need to have. We want to save this to entry. We do. That information is now being transferred up to our transfer database. Next step in the process is to select the mask. Again, can be populated in the field or can be created and set to the Web Demo or transfer folder that you select. In this case, we're calling it a test mask. After that's selected, you enter the size of the mask. In this case, we're going to identify it as a large mask. The operator is the person conducting the fit test. That's the name that will show up on any fit test record that is reported. Today's date is pulled from the system. The due date is 1 year from today's date based on the current OSHA standard, which has been selected. The next step is to actually start the fit testing process. Once we've completed our daily days fit testing, it's time to transfer the information back to our PC. To do that, simply remove the thumb drive from the instrument, and we'll take it back over to our FitPlus program and upload it into our main database. Now that we've completed our fit testing task, we've removed the thumb drive from the PortaCount and have returned it to our PC. Now, we open up our FitPro software, selecting the main database that we've identified as the holder of the fit testing records. In this case, we're calling it RAECO Demo. We go back to the database section and we do a flash drive exchange once again. This time, we're bringing the information from a source. In this case, looking at my computer, going to our jump drive, selecting the file that we've named, in this case, Web Demo. Our source has been selected as our RAECO data, where we want this information to go, and then we conduct an import. Once again, we get confirmation that the information has been successfully transferred. Now that the information is in the RAECO data main file, we can get to that information using all the functionality of the FitPro software. In this case, we can pull down the record, we can confirm protocols, look at the test person, the respirator type, we can view individual results on a specific test-by-test basis, look at the overall fit factor, pass or fail, and can also, at this point, print off a fit test card or even print off a paper fit test record. These are functions that are also available directly on the PortaCount, but should you choose to hold the information in one central location or in a master file, you can bring the information back in from the thumb drive into the FitPro software.